له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله تعظيما لشانه وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين. All thanks and praises are due to Almighty Allah, Lord of the worlds, the creator and initiator of the heavens and the earth. We testify there's none worthy of worship except Allah. We testify that our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is really his servant and also his messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon Muhammad and upon all those who tread upon the path of righteousness till the last day. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I admonish you and also myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should be Allah conscious secretly and openly. We should know that whoever fears Allah, Allah will ease the affairs of such a person. May Allah ease our affairs for us. Fellow Muslim brothers and sisters, he who does not know what is this world is that person who will make the world his goal. He who does not understand the life on earth is that person who will make the ultimate goal attainment of this world. But we should know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has summarized everything about this world in Surah Al-A'la, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. You always prefer, you make it your priority to attain the worldly affluence. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. But the hereafter is better, and that is the everlasting affluence if you are fortunate over there. This is not an admonition to us alone. Allah sealed it by saying, إِنَّ هَذَا لَفِي الصُّحُفِ الْأُولَى صُحُفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى. This that I'm telling you concerning the world, it is not you alone who is now carrying this message. The same thing I have said in the scriptures of those who came before you, it is there written in the scriptures of Ibrahim and the scriptures of Musa. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the world, if you understand it, is an unstable stage in our life. We didn't begin from the world. We began from somewhere. Then we came to this world. And from this world, we are transiting to another place. And that stage, which we call the world, is a stage that is not stable. A stage that has a lot of changes, which each and every one of us must understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the similitude of this world in Surah Al-Hadid, where Allah said, "I'lamu, be aware, annama al-hayatu dunya la'ibun wa lahu." That the entirety of the life of this world is just play and amusement. The entirety of the life of this world is just play. You are just joking. And it is just an amusement, something that you think in your mind and you become excited about it. But in reality, it is not there. The joy that you will think you are having
When you go down your inner self, the joy is not there. Wazina, the world is a place of adornment, a place that you think you can come and exhibit your beauty and handsomeness and the good things. Watafahurum bainakum, a place where you show pride among yourselves. I am better than him because I have a bigger house. I am better than him because I am richer. I'm better than him because I'm using 2019 car. He is using V or C or A. Tafakhurum bainakum wa takathurum fil amwali wal awlad. It is just the multiplicity of money and children. That is all. If someone is saying, I am better than him, just look at what is the person trying to show. It is just maybe money, or maybe we are more than them. I belong to this group and we are more. He belongs to the other tribe and they are, what do you call it, a minority. That is all. But Allah says, the world, كَمَثَلِ غَيْثِ, is just like a rain which fell on somebody's plantation. أَعْجَبَ الْكُفَّارَ نَبَاتُ. The farmers became happy when they saw the plantation green. Everything there is fresh. But it will remain that green that you are seeing. It will remain that fresh that you are seeing. ثُمَّ يَهِيجُ. A time will come, that green will begin to change. فَتَرَاهُ مُصْفَرًّا. You will one day see the green has turned to yellow. ثُمَّ يَكُونُ حُطَامًا. Then it will one day crumble and all of everything that you are seeing is no more there. You have taken it out. You want a new one to come. That is how the world is. Today, you are seeing your opportunities as if you are the best. A day will come. You are still alive. But when we are talking about the best, you are not the one that people will talk about. They will be talking about another person. Today you think your house is number one in Accra. You will be alive. A day will come when we are talking about number one house in Accra. It is no more your house, but it is a different house. And some people will be calling for your house that it is a dilapidated house. Bring it down. It is dangerous for people. It can kill. Demolish it. That same house for which you decided to kill other people to acquire. That same house for which you thought you were above everyone else. A day will come. You yourself will not feel comfortable sleeping under that same house for which people must die for you to acquire. Just like that farm, which was once green, later on it will become yellow and it will become scrambled. Everything is gone. Brothers and sisters in Islam, such is the world. There is one example about the world which says that the world is like a mother who has a lot of children. One of them very wealthy, another one very intelligent, another one very strong, another one a leader, another one what? But that mother has her eyes on top of her head. And so she cannot see until that thing goes beyond her head before she can see that this is what is happening. And then that mother happens to be looking for her children. She is looking for the rich child among her children. And because she cannot see what is beneath her, she will pick any child that she finds. Be raising the child. Be raising the child. If it is worth raising him in wealth. Raising him in wealth. Thinking that is the child that she's looking for. When she raises the child to the top of her head and she realizes, no, this is not my child, she will drop him and begin to raise another child. If it is about knowledge, She is looking for that child that is very, very intelligent. Because she cannot see, she will pick anybody. Then she will be raising him. Then obviously, as for this man, he is very intelligent. This man is very gifted. Then raising him, raising him. When she raises the child to the top of her head, then she realizes, no, 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 this is not my child. This is not the child that I'm looking for. She will drop him. One day will come. You are talking about knowledgeable people. It is other people that will be mentioned. That person who used to be the top in town is now faded. Nobody talks about him or her. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one day Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam slept on a mat. When he woke up, all his lungs were full of marks from the mat, because the mat was made from straw. So it was full of marks on his lungs. Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, when we saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in this state, we said, O Messenger of Allah, we will find something that is better for you to be sleeping on, so that these marks will not happen on your body. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said unto him, Mali walid dunya, what do I have to do with this world? What do I have to do? You want a very nice thing so that I will sleep and there will not be any mark on my sides? What do I have to do with this world? Innama ana illa karakib, I am just like a rider. Istadhalla bi dhilli shajaratin thumma raha wa tarakaha, I'm just like a rider who is riding under the scorching sun. Because the sun is so hot, the rider decided that let me go and have shade under this tree. After a while, the rider will definitely proceed to where or he is or she is going. So that is how I am in this world. Just a transit point. Just take some shade and then you move on. That is what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about this world. Servants of Allah, the world doesn't know you. If you think everything that you are doing is for the sake of this world, that world itself doesn't recognize you. At the time that you are in the world and you are actually occupying that position or you are having that wealth, that is when you think that the world knows you. But in actual fact, it is just an imagination in your head. The world doesn't know you. Ask yourself, your fifth grandfather, your fifth grandmother, what is his name and what is her name? You are a biological descendant of that person. But now, if you should be asked, what is your name, you will mention. The name of your father, you will mention. The name of your father's father, you will mention. The third one, you will mention. If you are fortunate, you go to the fourth. Mostly, fifth, sixth, seventh, you don't even know them. You've never heard their name before. You don't even know how they live their life, but you are their biological descendant. You, their biological descendant, have forgotten them and you've never even asked about them because the world has forgotten them. It is a must you also forget them. A day will come, perhaps in this same masjid, all of us will not be here, and those who will be here, when you ask them, have you ever heard of somebody called Salman? They say, no, 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 I've never heard this name before. Have you heard of somebody called Muhammad? No, 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 I've never heard this name before. And it is the same masjid where you used to pray, they are also there. But the world has forgotten you, they have also forgotten you. Servants of Allah, if you want the world to remember you, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other than that, if you disobey Allah, the world will forget you easier. The people of Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam, they disobeyed the commandments of Allah. And then finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed that nation entirely. In giving the account of what happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا شُعَيْبًا كَأَنْ لَمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. Those who rejected Shu'aib as if they never lived in those cities. The cities have forgotten them. كَأَنْ لَمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. As if they never lived there. Then Allah added, الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا شُعَيْبًا كَانُوا هُمُ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Those who rejected the message of Shu'aib, they were the losers. Allah didn't lose anything at all. The people of Salih alayhi salatu wasalam, when they also rejected the message of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though He has given them strength, He has given them power, so much so that Allah described them as alladhina jabu sakhra bilwad. They are those who carved in rocks and made their homes in rocks and in valleys, just because in those days they were not using these machines that we are using today. It was with hand that they will penetrate the rock and create their houses in there, and that is where they lived. But that didn't make them everlasting. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them in Surah Hud, كَأَنْ لَمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. We destroyed them as if they never lived there. أَلَا إِنَّ ثَمُودَ كَفَرُوا رَبَّهُمْ. The secret is that the people of Thamud disbelieved their Lord. That is why that thing happened to them. أَلَا بُعْدًا لِثَمُود. Far, far is the people of Thamud. I don't want to talk about them. I don't even want the world to remember them. Servants of Allah, as we said earlier, if we want the world to always remember us, then we should be remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina aman, O you who believe, ittaqullah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat li ghadin. Each soul should always look up, what have you put forward for tomorrow? Not about today, for tomorrow, for the hereafter. Always be thinking about that. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ فِيَا اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Because Allah is all acquainted with whatever you are doing. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهِ. Don't be like those who forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. And Allah made them to forget themselves. They forgot Allah, and Allah made them to forget themselves. Ulaika humul khasirun. They are those who are the losers. Then Allah says, La yastawi ashabun nari wa ashabul jannah. They will never be the same. Those who will go to Jannah and those who will go to the hellfire will never be the same. Ashabul jannati humul faizun. Those who will go to Jannah are the victorious. And so if you want to be victorious in this world and be victorious in the hereafter, always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make the world, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made it, a transit point. Whatever you got in this world is just to help you in that journey on which you are. Your wealth should be a provision for that journey. Your position should be a provision for that journey. Your authority should be a provision for that journey. Don't make this world your ultimate goal, because the world will forget you sooner. If you put water in a bucket and then you dip your hand into the water, you will be seeing your hand in the water and thinking that your hand has actually occupied a space in it. But when you remove your hand from that water, the water will come back the way it is. And then you will not even see any mark of where your hand was occupying. That is our situation in this world. It is today that you think you are somebody. The day you will die, the people of your house will eat, no matter who you are. The day you will die, the people of your house will drink no matter who you are. The day you die, the family, the immediate family will sleep no matter who you are. It is the first step to tell you that forgetting you is very easy. On the path of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and may we be resurrected in the group of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and may we be with the Prophet in Jannat al-Firdaus. Ala wa sallu ala Mustafa Nabi al-Karim. Faqad amarakum Allahu bithalik. Faqala azza min qail, inna Allah wa malaikata yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala abdika wa rasulika Muhammad. Wa radallahumma anil arbaati al-khulafa, ala immati al-hunafa, Abi Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali, wa ambakata sahabu rasulillahi ajma'in. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wa al-muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wa al-muslimin. Wa adhilla shirka wa al-mushrikin. Allahumma ahina muslimin. Wa amitna muslimin. Ghayra khazaya wa la maftunin. Allahumma a'ati nufusana taqwaha. Wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. أنت ربها ومولاها ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. There is a servant of Allah who says his wife has undergone a surgery. He wants all of us to remember him in our prayers. May the Almighty Allah give her quick shifa. May the Almighty Allah give her quick shifa. And the daughter is also pregnant and there are complications. May the Almighty Allah ease all those complications. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease those complications. Another servant of Allah who has been very, very helpful to Islam, we are praying to Almighty Allah that the way he is helping the deen, may the Almighty Allah help him too. And all of us are people with our needs. Allah knows them better than we do. May the Almighty Allah solve our problems for us. May Allah solve our problems for us. Allahumma alayka tawakkalna. وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين. اللهم أنت بحوائجنا عليم وعلى قضائها قدير فاقض لنا حوائجنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. وصل اللهم وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الأخيار وسلم تسليما كثيرا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب